Leia here from leiafirstsight.com, and in this video, we're going to look at a simple approach for dimensional analysis or unit conversions so that if you're doing math on the MCAT, you can quickly and easily know exactly what to convert, and of course, you can apply this to your chemistry and physics classes as well. You can find the unit conversion practice quiz and SI units to memorize for the MCAT cheat sheet on my website, leiafirstsight.com/conversions. When you first learned dimensional analysis, you learned a complex definition about going from one unit to the other as long as everything balances, and we're going to get back to that, but you also learned a lot of memorization. For example, you were given 36 grams of H2O and told to convert it into the number of moles, or convert it to the number of molecules, or the number of hydrogen atoms. You probably memorized a conversion factor. But the problem is, when you're doing a conversion like this, a lot of times I find myself stuck. If I have 36 grams of H2O, and I know that there are 18 grams per mole, do I multiply by 18, or do I divide by 18? If you memorize it, you risk getting confused, and I always got confused. What we want to do is figure out a way that you don't have to think about it, but instead you simply look at it and you know exactly what type of math to do based on what you're given so that you can quickly move on to the next step and the next step. Say you're given 7 minutes and you're asked to convert this into seconds. You know that there are 60 seconds in 1 minute. So do you set this up as 7 minutes multiplied by 60 seconds or divided by 60 seconds? Same question. The trick I'm going to show you takes a while to learn, but it's very fast and easy to apply once you get it. So bear with me as we slowly build up the logic step by step so that once you get it, you can quickly and easily apply it to any chemistry, physics, or conversion problem. Why? Because on the MCAT, you don't have a lot of time, and you definitely don't have a calculator, so you need to get past it quickly. And the shortcut comes from the multiplication property of 1. Any number multiplied by 1 is equal to itself. So if I have 1 times 1, it equals 1. If I have 2 times 1, equals 2. 175 times 1 equals 175. Again, the number multiplied by 1 equals itself. But it doesn't have to be a simple number that you recognize. For example, you can take a duck multiplied by 1 and you get a duck. You can take a pencil, multiply that by 1 and you will get a pencil. It doesn't matter what you multiply or how it appears, so long as you multiply it by 1, it stays the same. Simple enough so far? Let's take it one step further. What if I introduce fractions? A number divided by itself is equal to 1. So 1 over 1 is equal to 1. 2 over 2 is equal to 1. 175 over 175, once again, equals 1. What if I change the number? 2 times 1 over 1 is just 2 times 1 equals 2. 2 times 175 over 175 is just 2 times 1, and that still equals to 2. Any number divided by itself is equal to 1, so that if you take a number and you multiply it by a fraction that consists of a number divided by itself, it's simply equal to that number, because the number times 1 equals that number. It should feel very, very simple up to this point, but I want to make sure it's crystal clear. What if we take it a step further? What if we change the fraction so that what we put on top, or the numerator, is slightly different, or looks slightly different than what we put on the bottom, the denominator, but if they still mean the same thing, it still equals 1. A pair over 2 is equal to 1, because there's 2 in a pair. If I flip it around and I divide 2 over a pair, that's still 2 over 2, a pair is 2, and that means it equals to 1. What if I take a dozen and I divide it by 12. A dozen is 12, that's equal to 1. And if I flip it 12 over a dozen, that's again 12 over 12 equals 1. Up to now, we're looking at just numbers, but for dimensional analysis, we need units as well. If the numbers are different, But the unit of one equals to a different number of another unit, we still get the same thing. For example, we discussed time as minutes and seconds. We know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. How does 1 equal 60? It's the unit that changes the value. Because 1 is not equal to 60, but 1 minute has 60 seconds in that 1 minute. So we can set it up the same way, as a fraction where the top is equal to the bottom. If we set 1 minute divided by 60 seconds, even though the numbers are different, knowing that 1 equals the other, I could set it up with either option as the numerator or denominator, and it still equals 1, and I can flip it as well. So I can set it as 60 seconds over 1 minute, and once again, that is equal to 1. This right here, if you get this, you will understand the trick for dimensional analysis. As long as what's on the top, or the numerator, is equal to or converts to what's on the bottom, the denominator, your answer, your value will be the same, and that means it equals to 1. And so if I start with a number, say 9, and multiply by fractions that equal each other until I'm blue in the face, 9 times 1 over 1 times 2 over 2 times 175 over 175 times a dozen over 12 times 2 over a pair, it's all just saying the same thing. 1 over 1 is 1. This is 1, this is 1, 1, and 1. 9 times 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 is simply equal to 9 because we multiplied it by a whole lot of 1s. What the heck does this have to do with unit conversions? The idea behind unit conversions is simply converting from one type of unit and its given numbers to another type. Going back to our question of 7 minutes, converting that to seconds, we need to understand that the number for minutes is very different than the number for seconds and apply this idea of multiplying by itself so the value doesn't change. If I can give you 7 minutes in the equivalent number of seconds, meaning the number of seconds that exactly equals to 7 minutes, the number itself changed, but the value, the true value of the number has not changed because the unit was converted accordingly. And now you can forget all of the equations that you memorized and simply remember this one new equation. Given times ratio. We are given a certain value. We need to convert it to another unit. So we need a ratio that equals to 1. As long as that ratio equals 1, we can cancel out the units, do the math that is obvious in front of us, and convert the value. In this case, we have 7 minutes going to seconds. Given is 7. Always, always put your units. You want to make sure you know what you're converting and also know what to cancel. What ratio are we going to use? We need a ratio that converts one unit to the other. In this case, we have minutes to seconds, and we know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. We have two ways of writing this equation. We can write 1 minute over 60 seconds, which is equal to 1, or we can write 60 seconds over 1 minute, which is also equal to 1. Which one do we use? When we're setting up the ratio, that's multiplied by a fraction. We need the unit at the bottom of the fraction. We need the denominator to have the exact same unit as our given. This will allow us to cancel. If we have an equation set up, minute on top, minute on bottom, that's minute divided by minute, minute over minute equals 1, it cancels out, and whatever is left will be the right answer. So then we simply find the form of the equation that puts minutes in the denominator rather than the numerator. And here we have the second one, which is 60 seconds divided by 1 minute, because 60 seconds equals 1 minute. The minutes cancel out, and that leaves us with 7 times 60. You should know how to do this in your head. 6 times 7 is 42. Add the 0 gives us 420. The only unit left is seconds, and that gives us 420 seconds equals to 7 minutes. How do you know that you did this the right way? How can you quickly catch that it's not the other way around? Let's see what happens. If we set this up as 7 minutes, but use the wrong equation as 1 minute over 60 seconds, we can't cancel anything out, can we? What we have here is 7 divided by 60. In this case, you can round it up slightly and say that's about 7 over 70, where we made the denominator slightly larger, so the answer will be smaller. But 7 over 70 is 0.1, so it'll be slightly greater than 0.1. So let's put our answer as approximately 0.1. But the units for the answer are minutes times minute, because nothing cancels. That would be minute times itself, or minutes squared divided by seconds. I don't know about you, but I have no idea what minute squared per second means. And because I can't cancel it out, I know this is wrong. For the first one, I had minute times second over minute. And if we look at it written out, it's minutes times seconds divided by minute. Minute over minute cancels to give me 1, and that's 1 times second times 420, which is just 420 seconds. You can do this for any conversion, and it will always fall into place. Let's try this for the water example. We said 36 grams of water converted to moles. How do we set this up? Once again, given times ratio. In this case, we are given 36 grams of water, and we want to convert it to moles. So we need to know the relationship between grams of water and moles of water. For this, you can reference the periodic table or use the one linked in the description. And you'll see that the mass of hydrogen is 1, oxygen is 16, which gives us 18. We have 1 mole of water is equal to 18 grams. We can write that one of two ways. 18 grams over 1 mole, or 1 mole over 18 grams. Which one do I use? If my given is in grams, then I need to be able to divide by grams. Which one has grams in the denominator? The second one, 1 mole over 18 grams. This allows me to cancel out the grams, leaving me with just the unit of moles. We're converting from grams to moles, so that's ideal. And then we do the math. 36 divided by 18, well, 18 times 2 is 36, so 36 divided by 18 is 2, and that gives me 2 moles of H2O. At this point, you either get it or you don't. If you get it, make sure you move on to part 2, where we go through some more advanced conversions, including multiple unit conversions. If you don't get it, rewind the video and review this concept again and again until the concept of given times ratio, so that the ratio cancels, clicks, because once you get it, everything becomes so much easier. You can find additional MCAT chemistry videos on my website, layerforsci.com/chemistry. And if you still have trouble doing math without a calculator, remember, you can't use a calculator on the MCAT. Simply visit layerforsci.com/MCATmath, where I take you through all the different concepts in math that you have to do on the MCAT, and I show you tricks and shortcuts for how to do them without a calculator. The link again, layerforsci.com/MCATmath.